Welcome to Nine Bob Note with Paul Isles Rush and Ken Moss.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Nine Bob Note. I am Paul.
And I'm Ken.
Hi, Ken.
Hello there. What have you got for us this time?
Well, I'm afraid it's that time of year again, Ken. It's time for the birthday honours.
Who is being awarded the badge of gayness this year?
Well, I don't think he needs another badge of gayness. This year, I am going to bestow the highest honour in the land on Sir Elton John.
Oh, I've never heard of the man, so who is he?
he's a little-known singer. Elton John is currently in the, towards the end of an epic farewell tour. He said it's going to be his last tour. He wants to spend some time with his husband and kids before he gets elderly and infirm. Mm. And the end of that tour is going to coincide with a headline set at Glastonbury. So yeah, I thought it'd be quite nice to sort of celebrate Sir Elton in all his glory. And I'm sure there'll be edited in lots of clips of some songs. Certainly in recent years, he has done an awful lot of work for the gay community, for the LGBT plus community, particularly his activism in the field of HIV and AIDS. So the Elton John AIDS Foundation that he set up has raised millions and millions of pounds, and it's been donated to various AIDS charities. And
it's a very unfortunate time for me to burst out sniggering, but I've just called to mind, I think there's a Little Britain sketch a few years ago where he was doing an interview, a mock interview with somebody, and they were just massively playing up with gay innuendos.
You've had a very successful career. So successful, in fact, that you've been knighted by the Queen. Have you met many queens?
Loads.
Yes.
More than I can ever have imagined.
Really? Yeah. Really? Yeah. You're very successful, aren't you? Yeah. And I should imagine it would be very nerve-wracking meeting Her Majesty. What's it like kneeling before a queen? Do you get a lump in your throat?
I've never been a huge music fan. It's just one of those things that's been in my life, but I've never gone out and bought albums and raved about albums like people do. But he is there. He's permeated British music for, 50 years at least?
Yeah.
And my first exposure to Elton John was Mum and Dad had Goodbye Yellow Brick Road in their record collection. And it's a very distinctive cover.
Yeah.
But he's the most unlikely looking guy to have lasted this long. And it's a testament to his actual musical talent that he has. And he's another one. He's grown into it. He's far, I'd say, certainly, did he peak sort of in the 90s, 2000s? Because he was just everywhere in those days. The whole Four Weddings and a Funeral, Lion King period. And it was all very much him. Because he collaborated with Bernie Taupin a lot and Tim Rice on a few things. So he's quite a musical giant now. And there aren't many from that era left.
No. And he's certainly been through the mill. He's not had the easiest of lives. He has struggled with addiction to various things, including shopping.
Bad habits kick.
Yeah. And he also... He will be the first person to tell you he's not the nicest person.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I read his autobiography and it's very direct. I mean, you know, he has opinions. He's not awful about people, but if he meets someone and he doesn't like them, he will tell them. And I can imagine he's not the easiest person to get along with in real life. You know, if you had to work with him, he is renowned for his diva strops and for calling the press rude, vile pigs. I think that's one of his
well,
favorites.
That's true. That is true.
Yeah. But yeah, he was married to a lady. Although, according to his autobiography, it was sort of widely known that he was gay at the time. And yeah, it was just one of those things that he was like, you know, perhaps you should get married. You know,
to cure yourself.
Well, yeah, and just for the, you know, for the public persona, I think he was trying to break America at the time. But yeah, since then he's been with his partner David Furnish for a very long time.
It seems like yesterday when it all broke that he was together with, officially with David, but it is probably about 25, 30 years now.
Yes, yeah, they were one of the first couples to get a civil partnership. So they were like the flag bearers for civil partnerships when they first came out. And they also have two boys, Zachary and Elijah, I think. But I might have just made that up. One of them is definitely called Zach.
The irony, naming your children after biblical characters.
Yeah.
The Bible tells you what an abomination you are.
Yes, there must be something, something in there. But yeah, I think he's just... He just seems like one of those people. He's got so much to say. And as you say, he's so talented. You know, the songs that he's written, we all know them. Everyone's got a favourite Elton John song. And then there's the sort of Elton John moments as well that have sort of been peppered through our lives. Like Princess Diana's funeral.
Yes.
Goodbye, England's rose. May you ever grow in our hearts.
And just to have been there sort of through all that at the same time that he was going through all kinds of personal stuff. And as you say, for him to still be going, and for the fact that he has chosen to bow out with this tour rather than have to do it on, you know, sort of health grounds or, you know, God forbid something awful's happened to him. But it's quite a testament to his strength, I suppose.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'm skeptical as to how farewell his tour is going to be. The guy's a natural performer. It's not only that he's good at it, he clearly loves it. And how many performers have we seen that are doing a farewell tour? No, this is it. This is absolutely it. And then there's another concert somewhere else, or they pop up doing something. I hope he does. He's just one of the, I don't like it when people of that level of talent do finally retire, because it just seems like a terrible waste of talent. So I can understand the touring bit, but I hope we've not seen the last of him
performing.
Yeah,
I think that was the element of it that he did struggle with the most, the being on the road. His, you know, his boys are growing up and he's not gonna see them. When the babies, you can take them with you, can't you? But when they need to be settled down in school, so he's not been spending as much time with them. And I suppose that element, whereas if he just, you know, did like a show a year in the London Palladium or something, that'd be, I'm sure he could have his arm twisted for a bit of a comeback.
Wonderful image in my head of him with his baby boys just hidden in the grand piano, just between songs, feeding them, lifting the lid.
Like thinking off the British Empire. A very niche reference.
But yeah, even without sort of really knowing Elton John, because like I say, he came back to prominence during the 90s, primarily songwriting for shows and his music in films and things. Stuff that I'd not necessarily known was Elton John, I then started to recognise him. I think that you, and I've still got it somewhere, you made me a mixtape while you were at uni, and I've still got it, and on there somewhere is Crocodile Rock.
Ah.
Yes. So... Yeah, I must dig that out and convert it. You made me this wonderful playlist.
I wonder what's on it. That'd be really...
I'm just trying to think what was on it now. There was certainly Crocodile Rock and Xanadu and... I know, it was an eclectic mix, but it was lovely stuff. It was just... Yeah, so I played that to bits in the car. Yes, anyway, a trip down the yellow brick memory lane.
Yeah. Yes. And I'm sure he would appreciate being part of the soundtrack to our lives. Yeah.
But yes, he was, it still is. Because he's in his, is he mid-70s now?
I would say so, yeah.
Come on, Oracle, how old is Elton John? Born Reg Dwight in 1947, 25th of March, the Immaculate Conception, 75. And his first spouse was Renata Blauel. Married 1984. 84? I didn't realize it was that late. Divorced 1988. He married David Furnish in 2014. Yes, thank you, Wikipedia. Yes, certainly an interesting chap.
Yes. And if you I don't know if you've seen the film Rocket Man.
I wish I had. No, not yet. It is on the list.
It's a very, very good film. It's a sort of slightly fantasized version of his life. So it's not particularly realistic.
Mm.
But yeah, really, really good. And a lot of the situations in that were taken from his autobiography. And some of the situations in there are so ridiculous that you think they could only happen to Elton John. But yeah, he talks a lot about some of his other, there's a lot of name dropping in there. He's got, you know, friends with people like Rod Stewart and stuff, but they all had nicknames for each other, women's names, you know, like they called each other Doris and Betty.
Mm.
Like that. It's really, it's quite sweet. But some of the, you know, the sort of bitchy messages that they send to each other, and he plays awful, awful practical jokes on some of the, I can't remember them off the top of my head, but some of them, you know, are really quite mean, and you just think, wow. But yeah, there was one, and I'm sure it was Rod Stewart, and he was on stage in a, you know, like a big arena tour, and Elton John did something to him that was just, you know, like just so bad. But yeah, he's got like this wicked sense of humor that I hope he passes on to his kids, because that kind of thing should not be wasted, never mind songwriting talent. the jokester in him is what we get. But yeah, I thought, as he is, or he claims to be retiring from touring, let him go with this, possibly the ultimate accolade.
There is no higher honour in the gay world.
Exactly, yes. Sir Elton John, the Pauline Birthday Honours 2023.
Yes, Queen! Yes, Queen! Yes, Queen!
Well, on that note, we will sign out. Possibly play us out with a bit of Elton John, if you can find some in the back catalogue.
I'll hit the randomizer and see which one of Elton's records comes out.
Yes, and we will be back very shortly with more fun and frolics.
Well, thanks for listening, kids. We'll be back soon.
Bye.
Nine Bob Note featured Paul Isles Rush and Ken Moss. Title music was by Mark Scheiman, and the programme was produced by Maverick Productions. For more information, please visit maverickproductionsuk.blogspot.com or find us on social media.